Hey, what's up guys? Sean here. So in this week's video, we're gonna prep and season this tiny little Dutch oven. Let's get it. So before we get into this video, I wanna thank everybody who has subscribed. So we just hit our 1,000 subscribers. So in the next few weeks, I'll be doing a live stream and we will be doing a 1,000 subscriber giveaway. And I can't wait to get into that. I've got a few cool things that I want to give away. And I really, really appreciate all of your guys' support and everyone who has shared the videos, hit that like button, left comments on there. All that stuff has helped us get to 1,000 subscribers. I really, really appreciate it. So, this week is definitely not an adventure video. I apologize. I'm a little bit hobbled. I've got some bursitis in my right heel. Can't barely walk. But I'm hobbling around out here so we can do this video for you guys. So, what we're going to do today is we're going to prep and season this Dutch oven. And then, if everything goes right, we're going to make a nice little meat lover's breakfast casserole. But the first thing we got to do is get this thing prepped and seasoned. So let's get into that. Okay, so to start off with, this is a 2-quart Stan Sport Dutch oven. Now, these are not a Lodge quality Dutch oven. This thing only cost me about $23 on eBay. But that doesn't mean it can't be a good Dutch oven. So the problem is that, as you can see, probably, they put this quote-unquote seasoning on it. And that seasoning is so rough that you can hear how rough that seasoning is on there. And we need to get rid of that so we can actually build a good seasoning back up, a good non-stick seasoning back up. So we've got some work to do. Okay, so if you are a die-hard cast iron lover and you can't stand the idea of me sanding this thing down, now's the time you're probably gonna wanna look away. Because we are fixing to go to town on this thing with this little orbital sander. I've got a few different grits of sandpaper. I've got an 80 grit and a 220 grit. And then I've got a little wire wheel just in case we need it to get inside the corner. So let's go ahead and get into this, because here in a little while, we're gonna need to head out to the Green Frog Saloon and get this thing seasoned up. Okay, so like I said, we have an 80 grit and a 220 grit. So we're gonna start out with an 80 grit on the sander. Now this 80 grit is really abrasive, so it's gonna make quick work of getting this rough surface down. And then we'll switch over to a 220 to try to smooth everything out, and then we'll start seasoning it. Well, as you can see, this is a little bit too big. I didn't take into account that this was going to be too big to fit down in there. So we got this hand sanded down pretty good inside here, but I can get these flat surfaces in here with this. Okay, so now you can see this is a lot smoother than it was before, and that's just the 80 grit. I haven't even done the 220 yet, so the 220 should definitely help this polish up a little better. All right guys, this is so much better than it was before. So much better. I've got to admit, there was a little more elbow grease involved in that than I initially intended it to be. But because this is a 2-quart Dutch oven, it's much smaller, and really didn't think about the little mouse sander not being able to get down in there. But we were able to get it, no problem. And this thing is much, much smoother than it was before. and all I've done now is sand it. Now we've got a nice smooth surface to start with. We need to go get the grill fired up and get the temperature up on that thing and get this thing seasoned. All right guys, so we are back out here at the world famous Green Frog Saloon. Well, actually not world famous, but a lot of people, well you guys have probably heard about it anyway. It's my outdoor kitchen. But what we're going to do today is we're going to go ahead and get the grill lit up so we can season up this cast iron Dutch oven. Now this is going to be a process we're going to have to do several times. And it's not going to be a one-shot deal. So we're going to have to season it, let it heat up, let it cool all the way back down, re-wipe it down, season it, let it cool back down. We'll have to do it a few times to build up a good seasoning on here. But before we do that, we got to get this thing started. So I'm going to use some of these little tumbleweed fire starters to get my chimney started. I really like those things. They work really good. Okay, so I've got this thing actually on the griddle right now, just warming up. I don't want it hot, but I need to warm this thing up, make sure it's good and dry. That way when I put the oil on it, it'll take the oil real good and it'll soak the oil up in there. So got this thing warming up right now. Shouldn't be but a couple seconds, it'll be warmed up. Then we're gonna actually use some avocado oil on this thing to season it. So let this thing warm up for a second and then we'll get to it. Okay, so this is warm enough that it's just barely, you can just barely touch it and leave your hand on it for a second. So we're gonna actually use some of this avocado oil. This actually is from my wife's soap making oil, but it's the same thing, it's just regular avocado oil. We're not gonna need much, so we're gonna put some in there and we're gonna wipe this thing down real good. Wipe all the surfaces down, and we don't want a heavy coating on it. Real thin coating is what we're looking for. We're going to go ahead and wipe down the whole oven, the outside and everything. Now that lid has gotten pretty hot, so can't hardly touch it. I'm going to have to be careful with it. Well, since we're re-seasoning stuff, we might as well throw another coat on the griddle while we're at it. Doesn't take much. All right, well, now we just got to wait for the grill to get heated up. We'll probably put a couple extra coatings on this while we're at it. It's not going to hurt anything. But I think since we're at the Green Frog Saloon, we should probably have a drink, right? All right, so today we're going to do the Pendletons with my Dr. Pepper. That's the Dr. Pepper and cream soda in my good old-fashioned ball quart jar. Once again, thanks for all the support, guys. This one's for you. Cheers. On to a million. Okay, so now we've got the coals in here. We're just gonna close this thing up, let this thing get up to temperature. So we need to be somewhere around 350, 400 degrees, somewhere in there. And we'll have to try to hold that for about 45 minutes or so. Then we're gonna take it out of there and let it cool completely back off. And then we'll go through that cycle a few times. So we'll let this thing heat up to a good temperature. We'll get started. She's gone back to mama. All right, guys, so we got the grill heating up. We'll throw that Dutch oven in there, let it run for about 45 minutes while we sit out here, enjoy our mixed drink, and listen to some old country. Well, wouldn't make much sense to get those coals hot and not use them, so we got the Dutch oven in there seasoning right now, but I'm going to go ahead and get us some potatoes cut up. We'll cook us some potatoes on the griddle over here, and then we'll cook these steaks here on the grill. Once we get the Dutch oven off there, the coals will still be hot. We'll cook us a couple steaks. Okay, so on the steak and on these potatoes, I'm just using this Kinder's blend. This has got salt and pepper and garlic in it, everything I need, and it's all in one little shaker here. I'm really enjoying this Kinder's stuff. If you haven't tried it, you should try it. I'm gonna season these things up real good. I'm gonna just shake it up on all of them. Like that. I'm gonna throw a little butter on the griddle and get them cooking. Throw a bunch of butter on there. Am I the only Jamie Johnson fan out there? Been paying my bills, but you can't cash my check. Alright, so we got the griddle turned way down now. The Dutch oven are through with that first heat cycle. We're taking them out, letting them cool, and I'll have to do that a couple more times. I'm not gonna make you guys go through that, so I'll do that a couple more times. But now we're gonna go ahead and get these steaks on the grill while the coals are hot. All right, so these things have pretty much cooled down. I can touch them. So I'm gonna go ahead and wipe them back down again and then get them back in here over the heat and go back through that cycle again. So, I think we're gonna throw these things back in there, get that steak off of there, go have some dinner. Catch you guys in the morning. Hey, good morning, guys. This is a blues Sunday morning, so sitting out here at the Green Frog listening to some blues. Got the grill starting back up. Now, I know I'm cheating. I'm not doing this over a campfire, but I'll be honest with you. I can barely walk because of this bursitis in this foot, so I'm doing what I can, so you guys will just have to excuse me on this one. But this cast iron Dutch oven went through about three different cycles last night. It changed a little bit of color. Now, you're not always going to get that, or you're not ever going to get that nice thick black coating right off the start. So it'll start changing color, and then over time it will deepen up. I'll show you what I got over here, and then I'll show you what we're going to do for brunch this morning. All right, so as you can see, we've actually started getting kind of a bronze gold kind of tone to it, and that's okay to start with, and it's nice and smooth, so I think this is going to work out really good. Okay, so for brunch, we are going to do a meat lover's hash brown casserole. Very simple. Now, I could go ahead, build me a fire out there, and cook everything in this Dutch oven. But I'm not going to do that this morning. So what I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to brown my meat, cook my bacon, my hash browns, and all that stuff on the griddle over here. I know I'm cheating. But I'm going to brown all that stuff on the griddle, get it cooked up. We'll assemble it in the Dutch oven, and we'll do the final cooking in the Dutch oven on the grill here. I apologize. This is not how I had this thing planned, but unfortunately, it is what it is. I'm just having to do what I can. So we're going to get this stuff cooked up over here. When these coals get good and hot, we'll transfer everything to the Dutch oven and get cooking in that. Okay, so this is a meat lover's hash brown casserole that I'm making. So what we've got here, I went ahead and cooked a pound of bacon. I probably won't use all of it, but we'll have it for bacon bits and stuff. I'm gonna use this pound of Jimmy Dean sausage. May not use all of it, but we can use the rest of it at another time. I've got 5 eggs. I got some hash browns. These are the little cubes. I've got some cheese that I'm letting get too close to the griddle. And then I've got just a little thing of milk to mix in with the eggs. So this is just a recipe kind of off the top of my head. I've seen a few of them, and we used to do something similar to this, but we used bigger pieces of potato and some breading and stuff like that in there, but I didn't want to do that. The hash browns is bad enough. So but this is kind of just off the top of my head and some things that I've seen. All right, so we got the bacon all crisped up. We're gonna scoop this bacon out of here. I've got a bowl with some paper towels in it, get all that grease off of there. We're gonna start cooking our sausage. Thank you. All right, well, I think we've just about got our potatoes cooked up. Potatoes are looking good, so we're just about ready to get all this stuff mixed up. I'm gonna go ahead and get these off of here, get them all together, and then we can kind of shake them up. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my sausage, bacon, and potatoes in the bowl, get them all mixed up real good, and then we'll transfer those over to the cast iron Dutch oven. And then we'll mix our eggs up and everything, pour it all right over the top of it, and get it on the coals. I'm gonna just shake all this up, get it kind of evenly distributed. Something like that. Then we're gonna put this in the Dutch oven. What oven it'll fit anyway. All right, I'm gonna save that much of it. We might use that later. Okay, so I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and add some of my cheese. I got sharp cheddar and some mozzarella, and I'm gonna mix basically equal parts. I'm gonna put some of that cheese in my eggs, pour it over the top of everything, get it all mixed up good, and then let it set, cook, and then just before we're done, I'll sprinkle some more cheese on top of it, put me some coals on top of the Dutch oven, and brown that cheese, and I think we should be good. Well, it looks like I'm putting the cheese on after, anyway, it all just clumped up on top, so, best laid plans, right? Oh well. We'll just scatter it all out, something like that. Now, if you look, I have made a ring of coals down here just like I would if I was on the ground. Now all we gotta do is wait. So I'm gonna sit here and keep my eye on this thing. Every now and then I'll rotate and make sure I'm getting a good heat all the way around it. Then here in just a little while, as soon as I feel like that's about done, cause really all I gotta do is get those eggs good and cooked. And as soon as I feel like that's good and done, I'll put me some more cheese on top of it, put me some coals on top, brown it up. I think we'll be good. So now, while I'm waiting on that to cook, I'm gonna get my area cleaned up here, drink a little bit more of this coffee, and listen to these blues. I just checked this thing and it looks like the top isn't cooking. It's melting the cheese, but the eggs are still kind of real soft and jelly. So I went ahead and threw some coals on top of that, start cooking that thing from the bottom and the top. And here in just a few minutes, we'll add a little bit more cheese to it. So I don't have the tools like a lid lift or anything for this. So I've just got a little piece of steel that I bent to lift the lid. But I think in a future video, we're gonna get the forge out and get some tools and get some of this old steel and make a lid lifter and a few other tools to go with this kit. So let's open this thing up and see what it's looking like. Oh yeah, it's looking a lot better now. Matter of fact, I think we can add some more cheese to it. I think I want to add me some more mozzarella. I like it really cheesy. Let's add us some more sharp cheddar. Oh, that should be good. Now when I pulled it off, it was like this, so I think we'll just go ahead and turn it about 90 degrees. Let her cook. Well, we're pretty much cooked all the way through, I think. I went ahead and put some more coals on top of this so we can brown that cheese on top and get, you know, some top heat going down and brown that cheese up real good. We should be good here in just a minute. Alright guys, so I think we're pretty much done with this. I think we scooped some of it out and see how it tastes. Oh man, look at that. It's about perfect, right? Well, I'm about to get that other little piece. Get volunteered. Oh, look at that egg. Perfect. Well, it keeps volunteering, so. Alright, guys. So, that looks really, really good to me. It cooked perfectly. The eggs are cooked all the way through. They're browned. And what I love is the fact that it basically pulled cleanly off the wall and off the bottom. So we've got a good base seasoning started on that Dutch oven. So let's taste this and see how it tastes. Mm-hmm. Wow. That's delicious. You would expect it to be delicious, but it really is delicious. Hot, but it's delicious. Little cheesy piece here. Very, very good. Wow. Okay. So I know this wasn't a super exciting video, it wasn't a adventure video, but what I plan on doing coming up is some campfire cooking videos. I know some people have requested that kind of stuff. Maybe some campfire recipes. I don't know. We'll see how that goes. But maybe we'll do some forging of tools for this Dutch oven. And maybe we'll make a tiny trivet to go with this thing. So I appreciate and I love each and every one of you for helping me hit that 1,000 subscribers. I truly, from the bottom of my heart, appreciate that. All my Patreon members, you wild bunch, I truly appreciate you guys for the support and for helping me get out here and do these videos. This cast iron Dutch oven was paid for by you guys, and I truly, truly appreciate you guys. So if you enjoyed watching this video, hit that thumbs up button for me. If you haven't already, hit the subscribe button, ring that notification bell, leave me a comment below and let me know what you thought about this video. And you can follow us on Instagram, and you can follow us on Facebook. So go over there, follow us on those two things, and I appreciate you guys watching. We'll see you next time.